Hello, everybody. This is Jerry DeMaio from mortgage-zoom.com and Family First Funding. And the topic for today is the weekly mortgage rate update for 2023. We're already past January. And so I'm going to ask, if you haven't done this before we get started on the weekly mortgage rate update, please don't forget, subscribe to the channel. And please, as always, don't forget to like this video. So what happened this week? It was a big week for mortgage rates. So early in the week, the Fed raised the Fed funds rate 0.25%, which was what was expected. And honestly, mortgage rates rallied with that. The Fed actually said in their statements that they see that really the first time they are admitting that they're seeing inflation start to come down. So that really good news for mortgage rates. And mortgage rates rallied hard to the best levels we had seen in quite some time. I mean, some of the best levels we've seen. And then we had a jobs report yesterday, and much anticipated, you know, non-farms payroll report and the unemployment report. And the news came in very puzzling. When I say the number exceeded expectations, you know, they were expecting 189,000 jobs to have been created during January. And, you know, markets were waiting to see if it came in better or worse. And not only it came in, you know, 2.5 times that number, incredible number. So, you know, there's a lot to explain with that. And then, you know, that pulled rates back up, you know, to the basically about where they started the week, to those levels. And what I'm going to bring on Barry Habib and his team from NMLS Highway to help explain some of that confusing news for yesterday's unemployment and jobs report. And let's go to the videotape. Here's Barry and his team from NMLS Highway.
A blockbuster jobs report, but there's more to it. In fact, when you take a deeper dive, this job report smells. Good morning, everyone. It is Friday. It's Jobs Friday, and we are down 40 basis points. Yes, we had a locking bias yesterday. It's a good thing that we did. It's not terribly bad in the bond market after a blockbuster jobs report, much, much bigger than expectations. I'm going to let Dan break down the numbers for you first, but there's a lot more here than meets the eye. And I think as traders kind of catch on to what's going on and analysts try to catch on and we try and get the early jump, it's so nice to be able to this morning chat with people like John Walden, who was asking us for some of this. And we were kind of reviewing with Peter Bookvar some of this stuff. So a lot of this is mysterious. But what we're going to do here, Dan, is take it step by step like we do every day and break it down, right?
Yes, we will. Let's take a look at some of the numbers at face value and then get into some explanation as to why we could be seeing some of this weirdness. So I've got a slide to share with you here. You can see that the jobs report, it was expected to show 185,000 job creations in the month of January. Well, it blew that out of the water, 517,000 job creations. And even to add to the strength, the previous 2 months, November and December, were revised higher by 71,000. When you take a look now, remember, there's always two surveys here. There's the business survey, where you get that headline job creation number, and the household survey, where you get the unemployment rate from, but it also has its own job creation number. And boy, this was even stronger. It showed 894,000 jobs created. But of that, it is important to note that the vast majority were part-time at 606,000. Now, the labor force also showed a lot of strength and increased by 866,000. So you had strong job gains in this household survey. You had the labor force increase. Well, what did that cause? It caused the unemployment rate to decline from 3.5% to 3.4%, one of the lowest unemployment rates we've seen since the 60s. Now, this is in stark contrast to what we saw in the ADP report just this past Wednesday. That report only showed 106,000 job creations versus the headline jobs report this morning showing 517,000. But Barry, some things here don't make sense.
Yeah, it does smell for sure. The 894,000 especially is in sharp contrast. Now, I'm so glad you pointed out that over 600,000 of those were part-time, but still, and when you look at the 517,000 jobs, what gives here? Well, there's a reason. The BLS changed its methodology. And if you kind of read through it, it's pretty clandestine. It's very difficult to see. They don't give you specifics on it, but we did find something here on the household survey. Now, remember those 894,000 job creations that you see there? Well, the methodology change, which they call the population control effect. Boy, it sounds like that should be in a sci-fi movie, right? So the population control effect accounted for 810,000 jobs. You strip that out, and what was the actual job creations? 84,000, much more in line with the 106,000 jobs that we saw in the ADP report. Had this number been reported, it more than likely would have caused the, because remember, this is the household survey where the unemployment rate comes from, we wouldn't have seen the drop to that 1969 low of 3.4% unemployment from the previous month's 3.5. We would have actually seen it go from 3.5 to 3.6, maybe 3.7 in the unemployment rate. So therefore, this is why we came up with, ooh, that smells, because it does. There's something here that the headline is taking into consideration as, oh my gosh, if this were the case, Dan, we'd be in the throes of the greatest economic expansion ever, but yet all you're hearing is layoffs, layoffs. I feel like Jim Moore, layoffs? You know, so we are seeing layoffs everywhere, but yet where are these job growths coming from? Well, it's manipulation on spreadsheets and methodology as opposed to actual hirings.
Yeah, I mean, this is something that you need to have a little bit more of a deep dive and see how these numbers actually kind of shake out. But even Peter Bukvar saying, clearly this is attributing for the gains, but it's hard to quantify it. You know, it's pretty cryptic when you dive into some of these things. But
yes, Dan, and listen, what you all should know, there's a team of nine of us in the morning that go through this update, a lot of people that really help. We dug through this. As I told you, as we're on here, John Walden's called me. It's a mystery, and we're trying to figure it out. But the BLS is not very transparent in where these numbers came from. In fact, Dan, when we looked at the birth-death model and trying to get that, it showed something that we didn't even want to report this to you because it showed month over month, get this, negative 2.5 million jobs. So how do we get to positive 500,000? That's a 3 million job difference. It's hard to quantify. Take it with a grain of salt on the 517. Take it with a pound of salt on the 894. It's all created by adjustments, and it's not actual jobs. I think that the market is smart. And if this was a real number, we'd probably see the bond market down 100. But it's not, maybe more. I think it's quite possible that as people start to uncover some of these mysteries like we've already done, we're usually faster than most in doing this, they will start to see that maybe this is not the incredible jobs report that's been reported. By the way, Diana, an important aspect of the jobs report that I don't want to miss is the wage component.
Yeah, wages are important. When they go up, it helps things like affordability, but it does cause fear for things like wage pressure and inflation. And you can see it's certainly not helping the bond markets. So taking a quick look at the numbers, we saw average weekly hours went up from 34.4 to 34.7. And average hourly earnings, they were up 0.3% month over month. And they increased by 4.4% year over year, which was a slight moderation from the 4.6 we saw in the previous report. And average weekly earnings, they increased by a big 1.2% month over month and 4.7% year over year, all the way from 3.1% in the previous report. So you can see that this increase in weekly hours is certainly affecting the overall take-home pay and weekly earnings.
Yeah, Diana, that's the one that, you know, is probably the most damaging to the bond market is that one line right there. That's the one that's probably most damaging to the bond market today.
Exactly. And going into next week, it is a fairly quiet news week, but we do get some auctions on Wednesday, a 10-year note auction on, and on Thursday, a 30-year bond auction. So we'll keep a close eye there.
Oh, thank you, Barry. And thank you for all that information. And really, what does it say? So at the end of the day, after all this great news about jobs, the market rate should have gone up 0.5%. Or more with that jobs number, and it didn't. And it sounds like the markets have uncovered this. So we still have good news for mortgage rates. Again, and I've heard so much misinformation this week. I see realtors making posts. I see all kinds of insane information going out like, oh, Fed raised rates. People assume that's mortgage rates. Mortgage rates and the Fed are two different rates. They're not the same rates. So do not think when the Fed raises rates, mortgage rates go up. So that's your report for today. You know, you're probably still today in the high fives. We were hoping, you know, if the jobs number wasn't what it was, we could have been in the mid fives by the end of the day yesterday. Instead, we're remaining in the high fives right now. If you have any questions, if you want to go over numbers, if you want to find out about a grant program, if you want to find out what you and your family are eligible for, all you need to do, see up above, go to www.mortgage-zoom.com, and you can have a one-on-one appointment with me, Jerry DeMaio, and find out what works for you and your family. Also, for those who are interested in my $15,000, $10,000 New Jersey grant program, there's been some major changes to the program for the positive. Really, you know, I was able to do quite a few of them this week. With these changes, and the changes are great. The conventional, basically what's happened is on the conventional program where they give you the $15,000 grant, they've increased the income limits from like $90,000 up to like $170,000 in some areas. I mean, it's a huge increase, and it makes it a lot more families eligible. So if you have any questions, again, give me a call, reach out, go to www.mortgage-zoom.com to schedule your one-on-one appointment with me. Thank you again for joining. Please don't forget, subscribe to the channel. Have a wonderful weekend, everybody.